Hey YouTube, this is Jaden coming at you live from Alien Games. I'm having to redo this because the first time we did this, the computer didn't like it. So anyway, guys, I have my good friend Zane here. He's going to be showing you his Seal Dragon deck. And it's a pretty interesting build. Not one that you might think that'd be very good, but he's won quite a few locals here with it. So Zane, why don't you show it off?
All right. So Crusader Captain Zane of Fortune here to bring you my version of a Seal Dragon deck, which is Kagero, if anybody's wondering. Now, the deck doesn't have much variety that is possible to make it very consistent. But what I've done to it is not very unusual, I would say. It's pretty handy, though. So I'm just lining up my cards right now. So
I need to read this while you do that.
Oh, is that? Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. My gift to my friend Zane is out of my boxes today. I gave him my two copies of Unlimited.
Yeah.
Because he's the only player I've ever seen trying to play Dungaree.
And do decently with it, I'd say.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's very kinky.
Wow, that's actually not bad.
Yeah. You just lose so many cards off your deck, but it can be very effective, though. Very effective. Especially, like, every attack.
It's kind of like Nubatama meets Kagero.
Yeah.
Or... Wait, is he? No, Narukami.
Narukami, yeah.
All right, Zane, so why don't you show us what you got?
So, for the starter, I do have Seal Dragon Terrycloth. Now, that's the original starter minion deck. I do like it, but we can't really ignore our original roots of Conro. And Conro is honestly the one I use more often than I do Terrycloth. If there's a Vanguard that I absolutely need to get rid of, like, say, Crimson Lion Criff or something, then I might go for him. But if it's a deck that I really don't need to pop anything, or if I just really feel like I need a grade 1 and I don't have a good idea that I'm going to get one, because you never know. And I run a pretty even amount of cards in the deck, so if I don't see them, then I won't see most other cards and stuff. So my starter is typically Conro with the deck. Now, that leaves another Seal Dragon in the deck to be counterblasted, because all Seal Dragons do a counterblast for themselves. Conro, what he does is counterblast one, search your deck for any grade 1 or less, and put it in your hand. Now, Terrycloth, you put him in the soul, you retire any one of your opponent's rear guards. Doesn't matter what grade, and if they kill it, well, yeah, they have to kill it. And when it reaches the drop zone, they look at the top 4 cards of their deck. If they find a grade 2, they pick one of them, and they call it to a rear guard. Now, if they don't find any, then they just lost a rear guard. But it gives them a free interceptor, potentially, if they really want to. Now, some people don't use this until, like, late game, because then there's not many spaces for you to occupy and stuff, while at the early game you're giving somebody a grade 2. You don't typically do that. Helping out your opponent's not that great all the time, if you're trying to have an upper hand. So, for my trigger lineup, I have 4 Seal Dragon Shirtings, which are the heal trigger. 4 Seal Dragon, I don't know his name because it's hard to pronounce, draw triggers.
Arteek?
Yeah, I think so. Arteek.
Whatever.
It's a weird thing. Anyway, suck him in the soul as an act, give 3K to something. I run Seal Dragon Biela, so far that's 4 heal, 4 draw, 4 crit. And then instead of running the sand triggers, which is Dobby, I chose Gatling Claw Dragon. Because one, it can ping off starters, and two, it can ping off early boosters. Plus, it's another draw trigger that's really handy with a cross-ride deck, which I've made it to be a cross-ride somewhat, or at least more so than I was hoping. So, handy, very handy. So, for grade ones, we have Seal Dragon Quarter... Never mind that. So we have Seal Dragon Cursey. He's your ditch and draw for the deck. Kind of like Gojo back in the day, but not. So if your opponent has a grade 2, Vanguard or Rear Guard, you place it on Rear Guard, take a card from your hand, discard it, drop a card, draw a card. So usually I don't want to ride it, but nowadays I'm starting to ride it a little more often because the other effects of the deck are kind of better. So we have Seal Dragon Flannel, who's your 10k attacker if you have a Seal Dragon Vanguard.
Arcade Clone?
Huh?
Arcade Clone.
Oh, yeah.
Like Knight of Friendship Cake?
Yeah. Which, back then, you know, your only ones that were even close to that were double rares. Now they're just commons nowadays.
Which is nice.
Yeah, it's so easy to get a hold of now. Ks are so hard to find. So, Flannel, your 10k attacker. If you have Seal Dragon. Now, that only doesn't work in, like, one situation with this deck. but I'll get to that later. So I have 4 Cursey, 4 Flannel, and then 4 Rhinocross. So that makes 12 grade 1s. We have 18 grade 0s at the moment, and your Rhinocross is your perfect card. And it's better than Bree in the case that it's a Seal Dragon. So if you can, get a hold of those. If not, they work just fine. I had 3 Seals and then 1 Bree at one point, but you can just Conroe out the Bree if you really needed to, so it doesn't clutter your deck. So for our grade 2s, we have 12. We have 4 Hungry Hail Dragons, which is our 10k attacker. Lycogro didn't have enough of those already. We just get more. And this one looks cool, too.
And he's hungry as hell.
He's hungry as hell. Then we got Seal Dragon Corduroy, which is one of my favorite cards in the deck completely, who is the exact same thing as Terrycloth. You put him on rear guard, you can counterblast one, Seal Dragon, pick one of your opponent's rear guards, kill it, top 4, call it grade 2. Very handy if you want to snipe back row or especially behind their vanguard. And if they... You can call the unit to a occupied space, but then you're also losing a card still anyway for that. So it is a choice on your opponent's end, but yeah, it can't be completely broken because it used to be Counterblast Seal Retire 2 or less with, I think, Berserk Dragon, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's a little bit more fair for killing something potentially.
And there's a little bit of risk.
Yeah, there's a little bit of risk. It's all up to you. And now, the only problem with him is when it comes to Narukami or Gold Paladins, you typically help your opponent a lot. Narukami, you're killing one of your own stuff. Gold Paladins, they're possibly searching for more guys or killing one of your guys. Either way, it's risky, but I love it. I do. Then we have Seal Dragon Jacquard, who is your 12k attacker for deck grade 2. 4 of him. He's just handy. Preferably not riding him if you can help it. Most of the time, it's Corduroy. If I don't get Corduroy, Hungry Hell works just fine. Now we go to the grade 3s, which are where you have the most diversity. The only other diversity in this deck, if you're trying to go all seals, is Chambray. Seal Dragon Chambray, who is the booster for Seal Dragon Blockade, or either variation of it. Who's a 4k booster, unless you Soul Blast 1, which makes him a 6k extra, so 10k booster. It's alright. It's not going to happen all the time, though, sadly, because eventually you will run out, and you might get to the point where all I have left is my Seal Dragon Blockade and my Inferno, and you lose your cross ride if you got rid of him in your ship. So, yeah, so what I run in the deck for grade 3s is I run 3 Seal Dragon Blockades. Because on their own, they're really good. They came out in set 2, but they got reprinted. So, to tell you how popular it is, they even made a sub-plan about it. Or at least they had the idea to. Because they usually take little obscure things like Luquier made a Silverthorn clan. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, very sexy.
Very sexy. They have some nice looking units, yeah. I gotta say. So, yeah, we have 3 of him. Now, here's where it gets a little bit different. We have 1, count them, 1 Nautilus Drive Dragon. For 2 or 3 reasons. 1, only one I have, so can't help that. 2, it's a really good ability, and no matter when you ride him, he's going to be handy for the deck, especially no matter what you're riding over top. The best thing to do would be Seal Dragon first, blockade, ride over with Dauntless, and then cross ride and break ride over into him, and having 5 damage unflipped. Because you can have an ultimate turn then. If you want, I'll explain that in a second. So, yeah, Dauntless, what he does is... Oh, I forgot to mention. Seal Dragon Blockade, what he does is, during my turn, not just when he attacks, during my turn, your opponent cannot intercept at all. So, as you can see, calling grade 2s can help the deck at the same time as it can cause some issues. Dauntless, whenever you ride over top of it, it's your break ride from the deck. You get taken to your new vanguard, and whenever it attacks, you can discard 3 cards from your hand, stand your guy back up. Very handy. Then, last but not least, Hellfire Seal Dragon Blockade Inferno. So beautiful. So he's 11k base on his own, as is Dauntless. I run 4 of him, because he's the most important part of the deck, and my favorite card nearly of the deck. And what he does is counterblast 2 Seal Dragons, retire all grade 2s on your opponent's side of the field, and also just get 10k. Don't even have to retire anything or nothing. So at 13k base, he gets pretty good and stuff, and since we don't have a bar for the deck, the most we can swing for while being boosted is 20. Unless you run Chambray, which then it'd be 23. But swinging 20 every turn is pretty good, especially if your opponent has an older deck or at least a Vanguard that still has that original 10k base. You don't see them too often, but when you do, it's pretty sweet. And so the best combination with Blockade and Inferno is, yeah, ride him, Dauntless. Then you go into him, you have 5 uncounterblasted sealed counterblasts. You do his ability once, then you call, or you can either use his ability, Terrycloth, or you can use little Corduroy. Make them call a grade 2, use the ability once more. You just got an extra 30,000 to your Vanguard, and he's also going to stand up again, and you've retired a good amount of grade 2s in your opponent's deck, potentially 2 or more.
Can someone say, I need perfects?
Yeah, that's going to be needed. And then he's going to stand up again and most likely be boosted this time. And then you still have your rear guards to attack with, too. So, all in all, it's a very simple deck. You can play it any way you want to, and there's many ways to play it, even though there's very little support. You can just go back to the originals and add like old cards like Marie and stuff like that. No, wait, Bar and stuff like that. Just in case if you want that 21 column, I would definitely recommend it. I would love to, but I can't have the heart to take out any of my Sealed Dragons just to do that.
Well, you've won with the deck, too, so there's no reason to change it.
Yeah, I've at least won 2 tournaments and went top 2 and split with 3 other ones. So it's doing me pretty well, I think.
All right, guys. Well, in the comment section below, feel free to share your comments on the deck with Zane. Be sure to check out our new discussion. We're getting ready to film that, so be sure to check it out when it's posted. See you guys later. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
See you later.